turn me up.
What's going on, Boat?
What up? What up?
What's up, what up? Ross Devin, some of the gang here, waiting on some others supposed to be joining later on. But we in this thing, you feel me? ITC podcast, episode 38, ladies and gentlemen. It is election night. So I'm pretty sure majority of this podcast will be or may be talking about the election, following up on it. And I doubt we get a winner by the time we're done. But hey.
Yeah.
It's crazy to see how things turn out after this upload. But how you gentlemen doing tonight, man?
Chilling, man. Just glad to be here.
Wonderful.
Trying to figure out who gonna win this damn thing, man.
But y'all feeling like gonna take it?
It's looking like Biden may take it, bro.
Yeah.
From the last update that we received, it's looking like Biden may take it, but anything can happen, man. Especially when it comes to this country, anything can happen. So
anything's possible.
It's not set in stone.
Y'all see Trump trying to hit them lifelines and shut some stuff down. So, but it's I find it funny and sad at the same time.
Yeah, I think he's suing a couple states to.
Yeah, he's suing Georgia in an attempt to pause vote count
in the states. Yeah,
and he's suing Pennsylvania. And a lawsuit to Michigan. Oh my gosh, bro!
He's trying to force a recount in Wisconsin too.
That's insane, bro.
And it's crazy because people from some of the updates I was seeing, they were saying even if they did a recount, it still wouldn't even matter or go in his favor.
No.
I just feel like, man, look, it's a tough situation. If you're not winning, it shouldn't take all that. You shouldn't have to be doing all that. I personally, it looks like it's fair. Everybody's saying all the votes and everything that's going on is fair. So even if they're still counting, they say they're counting fair ballots or votes that was put in time or mailed in time. So it's like, why are we trying to say it's fraud? But I just personally feel like Trump kind of already put that little fraud thing in the air just in case beforehand. You seen him a while before when he was talking about during the, I believe their debate, he was just like, yeah, man, if they do these live-in ballots, I mean, mail-in ballots, got to be careful with that because they might be cheating or they might be over-counting ballots or dumping them. And so he kind of put that in the air beforehand so he can have something to kind of like piggyback on and say, I told you so, in case.
Right now they are waiting on Nevada to decide to count, to finally finalize their counts and stuff. So everybody making memes like, come on, Nevada, what y'all doing, bro? What? Why y'all taking so long? Come on, bro.
Come on, bro. I was thinking about today. I was like, man, I feel bad for the ballot counters, man. They got a tough job, bro. Shout out to them, bro. Three days. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm looking at them now.
Yeah, I see them in Atlanta going crazy over there. That's a lot of paper to go through, man.
And they already been through, I think they said, 168,000. They still got like 130, 30-some-odd thousand left just to submit.
See, we not really showing love to the right people right now. Right now, they deserve a trophy or something. They the real MVPs right now, bro, because they putting in a lot of work to make sure these balance and everything are counted and these votes are counted and stuff like that. So that's a lot because I'm watching it right now, bro. And they really, I'm talking about these papers are just,
I don't know if they're volunteers or, if they're getting paid for, but they volunteers. Help, but they need something.
Yeah. Some type of compensation.
Yeah. And I like any blessing. You can give me a cookie. Just give me something,
I'm going to need more than a cookie. I mean,
I'm just saying.
I'll be damned.
Just say thank you. You ain't just gonna be like, all right, y'all. Yeah, y'all, we done. Y'all can leave. Nah, you ain't gonna give me a thank you. Look at my hands. So
what happened?
Thanks.
Shout out to Chisel. But no, man. Yeah. So it's quite interesting, bro. I did see a couple of people doing a little rioting too. I don't know if y'all seen that. I was watching it on the news. It seemed like some of the people, Trump supporters, was kind of like going to some buildings outside protesting, telling them to stop yeah, counting.
They got that one. Then they also got the every vote counts rallies going on too, or marches, what they calling it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, something like that. So they, you know, in favor of the mail-in ballots, because you know he's trying to shut it down. I'm like, man.
He called an early victory yesterday though. Like, looks like we got it. Looks like we're gonna win this one.
he was already down in the polls.
I'm like, damn, bro. Because I mean, I guess he was just going. It was close, and in the states that he know he was gonna win in, you know, kind of going off of that as well. So I just went to sleep like, man, whatever. Like, because I was like, they ain't gonna be able to finish this tonight.
You got to look at it. I kind of try to look at it from his standpoint. He knows that if you think about it, majority of the people that are mail-in ballots are your senior citizens. That's really who they're opening up for.
Factuals.
And mostly in cities. If you think about it, most major cities are Democratic. Mm-hmm. And so he know if he can get those mail-in votes to help just the like you say, the jump ball states, he know he has no chance. So in his mind, he trying to throw everything out there, and then he know his people, you know, I won't say what I call them, you know, due to respect of our viewers, but, Trump supporters, you know, you can just look at how the media is. He'll say one thing, and they ready to ride.
Mm-hmm.
They standing by, bro. They the stand-byers.
Yeah. Stand-by.
Mm-hmm. Stand-byers. So, at the end of this election, man, how do y'all think it's going to go? Like, for whoever wins, how do y'all think the aftermath of this election, how do y'all think it's going to be out here in the communities and stuff?
I think it's going to be more or less the same, bro. Just a different atmosphere. Of course, there'll probably be some memes that are up.
No riots.
I don't think it's going to be no riots, bro. I think that's all just like scare tactics, bro.
Yeah.
Like, it's not going to be no riots, bro. Like, at the end of the day, it's just one of those type of things where your candidate lost. It is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, you still got to go to work tomorrow. You feel me? Right. Like, you still got bills you got to pay.
Okay,
you
know LeBron.
It's facts. Like, you still got to go to work tomorrow. You still got to take care of business. So, what's the purpose of you rioting because your person didn't get voted in or your posted person didn't get voted back in? Like, yeah. I don't know what to tell you.
I feel like it. I don't think it ain't going to be no riots, but harassing
is going to happen.
And I kind of felt that, like, on my way here before I hopped on. I was leaving my friend's house, and I seen a Jeep with a Trump flag. And I pull up on side of red light, and he was just sitting regular. And I guess he seen me, and he was, like, trying to get my attention. And he was doing certain things to try to get my attention. And I'm like, say, bro, this is Texas. Don't play with me. I'm going to just keep my eyes this way. But I got a good
peripheral. My lap.
Right. That, literally, it really was. And I don't drive like that. But, man,
that's
help
crazy.
Help protect yourself.
That's crazy, bro. Like, to realize we in the world nowadays to where you can't even have an opinion of who you feel like you want to vote for and not fear that opinion. You know what I'm saying? Like, you fear your opinion because other people are like, nah, man, this is who you should vote for, and they'll surround you, just like some of the videos we've seen where they were surrounding this one young lady.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I saw that video.
I think she was saying Black Lives Matter or something, and however it was going, she wasn't voting for Trump. She was surrounded by a bunch of Trump supporters. I even seen some white males telling her, come on,
yeah,
taking their shit off. It's like, bro, you that sucker. Makes you hard, like, that you gonna sucker. Square up with a young lady.
Like I was saying, man, they know not to do that shit in certain areas. They not coming down Reed. They're not coming down Scott. They're not coming down MLK. They're not going to Harm Clark. They're not going to Third Ward, even though it's gentrified. They're not doing that in Sunnyside. They're not doing that in South Park. They're not doing that down here. They know where to do that shit at, bro. They know where to keep that energy at. Keep that shit in Pearland.
In the cities.
You know where to keep that energy at, bro. You niggas, niggas ain't stupid, bro. They do that shit because she was by herself.
There she is.
If a motherfucker came out there, you know what I'm saying, niggas was rolling in slabs, rolling deep, shit would have went different, bro. I'm just saying. I'm just keeping the stat. Niggas would have been calling the cops.
Oh, a bunch of kapowows going.
Yeah,
on.
It would have been a powwow for real, man. A powwow mixer. That's what I call it. A lot of shit would have got mixed up. You feel me? So that whole video, that shit's just lame. It's just people trying to scare people. And it was funny because she was still flaming all them niggas, bro. Like, bro, you really trying to square up with a woman?
She was really holding her own, bro.
She was.
You squaring up with a woman, bro, with your tactical vest on. Get your ass in the truck, bro.
My biggest fear. Oh, what's up, Malisha, ladies and gentlemen? Malisha,
what's going down?
What's up, gang gang? Hey, everybody.
What's going down?
What's up? Southside.
She had to hit it. You stupid, Devin. No, I'm saying, but nah, like my biggest fear.
What up, vampire from Brooklyn? We ain't talking to you.
Damn, she go. She come in with that energy. Oh, see
crazy.
That?
Yes, she is.
Damn, you see that?
You see that? You see that energy she come in on, ladies and gentlemen?
What was you following? You was either smoking, sinning, fornicating, pastor, or
wow, wait. Damn.
Who got the award? Who got the award, Ross?
She got the award. Thank now.
You. Or
smoking, sinning.
You was the vampire from Brooklyn. Which one?
No. I wasn't nobody this year.
Did you pull the medallion out this weekend?
That medallion is somewhere in the ocean because I threw it away like last year. That's
I'm done.
Nah, you good.
I'm done. Only because you said Southside. I don't know.
She number one.
I got a I'm from South, so you know.
She number one.
She's definitely number one.
With a very strong lead.
Yep. At the end of the year. That's crazy.
At the end in the fourth quarter.
She's coming back, y'all.
She's coming strong, ladies and gentlemen. But now, what I was gonna say is my biggest fear is like getting a call from my wife or something saying that somebody following her, chasing her, you know, because of who she voted for, you know, them trying to antagonize her, you know, bully her. And yeah, I don't know. I just feel like I'll see red at that point.
And here's the thing. I don't believe all Trump supporters are like that. There's some civilized individuals. It's just the ones that feel like, you know what I'm saying, they living behind that Make America Great Again statement. You know what I'm saying? Like, they take that shit a little bit too far. So it's one of those situations where it's like, bro, you're really doing the most, and your dude may not even win. You're going to be feeling real sick. You're gonna be feeling real sick then, what,
lady? Well, honestly, whoever wins, it's gonna be a complete crap show.
So
Trump supporters are gonna be excited that he win if he wins, and they're gonna be mad if he loses.
They're gonna be gloating if they win, bro. They're gonna be, yeah, but I told you, boy.
Make America great again.
We're gonna out for a cold one.
Lil Pimp, come up here and
That was funny, bro. This nigga said Lil Pimp. That nigga.
How stupid do you look, bro? You trying to support a man? This nigga don't even call your name correct, like.
Right.
This nigga, and it should show people that, you know, clout is a dangerous drug, because that nigga hadn't been relevant since like 2016. So you know what I'm saying?
And I think that year he posted on Twitter somebody screenshot of him saying "F Trump."
Yeah. And the only reason why he's saying that because he quote unquote ain't trying to pay more taxes, but I'm sure. You don't even worry about your taxes. Your accountant does. And even then, at the end of the day, it still don't matter. Like, you're a sellout. So
you smoking it all up anyway.
Yeah, you're a sellout. He's a major sellout.
I didn't clarify what you're smoking.
And he's a sellout. But, hey, that's what happens when your music not popping. Your music not popping, you got to resort to stuff like that. That's
but you know what? It was sick, man. Like, I don't know, bro. Like, I think people really, 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 and I don't know how we gonna change this, but celebrities is like almost, they got so much power where people
political
really
figures.
Yeah, thank you. Like, they're like political figures to people. Like, people really get so invested when a celebrity say, "I'm endorsing such and such," or "I'm voting for." It's like, bro, that's cool. Yo, what you worried about really is not what I'm worried about. Like, we got two different, we're in two different tax brackets, you know what I'm saying? We have two different communities we live in, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of your words are not my words. So it's like, I can't just, I'll be like, ah, damn. But it ain't like, man, who else was it? The Wayne and all?
Oh, yeah, Wayne. Yeah.
Wayne and Q.
And a few people. I don't know if Q voted for him.
But a lot of people were definitely harsh on Lil Wayne. And my point is, hey, he can support whoever he want. That Lil Wayne's vote does not sway my vote. I'm sorry. I don't hold celebrities or entertainers to that high regard where, well, they said it, so that must be true. I'm These going with them. These are
different tax bracket problems, though. That's the thing. Like, most people get so riled up about, oh, what's up, Joe?
There he is.
What's going down?
The only thing about Wayne, though, what's up, Joe? Joe just joined, ladies and gentlemen.
What's going on, y'all?
Only thing about Wayne.
Oh my gosh,
bro. Tell us.
Hey, Carrie.
Hey, Joe.
We are recording.
Trying to be professional. But nah, the only thing about Wayne is I feel like it was a point in time that he made a statement a few years ago, if somebody could remember. And people kind of like got on his ass about it. And then he retracted, and people was trying to cover up for him, saying that, you know, Wayne really lives under a rock. He really be in the shell. He don't really be paying attention a lot to what be going on in the world. And, you know, they was trying to cover up for him because he made a statement about something. And black people was like, hello, Wayne, what the hell you talking about? But then now it's like with him endorsing Trump and him calling him a person that's in the community or whatever Trump, he made a comment about Wayne in voting and shit. And it's like, well, Wayne ain't never been the type of nigga that was like no activist or, you know what I'm saying? Like to the point to where he's like, hey man, we need to get together and come together and do this. You know what I'm saying? So that's the only thing about it that kind of just made me a little, you know, dim my eyes a little bit. But other than that, it, you know, to me, I'm just like, bro, he gonna vote for who he want to vote for. I can't hold Wayne to a higher regard than anybody else, especially if he don't have the background to come with his decision and all that.
Facts.
But yeah, Joe, you good over there?
Yeah, I'm good, man.
Yeah, to mute it.
Yeah, I did. but yeah, I'm good, man. Just chilling, enjoying this. What is this, Wednesday?
Yeah.
This one, which I thought was gonna let me know what this election is gonna look like, but I'm a little bit at ease today than I was yesterday around this time.
Yeah, I just went to sleep like, man, I'm about to roll
Most
over.
Most deaf.
Whatever.
Most deaf.
Yeah.
What people said. It don't matter. God in control.
Right.
When we start losing, that's okay. It don't matter who the president. Jesus still a king.
Jesus still reign on the throne today, tomorrow, forevermore.
He's the only one I'm worried about, which is true. But you was about to say something, Malisha.
Yeah.
I was saying, like, these are different tax bracket problems. People in the bottom class, and I'm in the bottom class, but I'm just saying I'm working class. So people in the bottom class are the ones that are just saying, like, how could he do that? How could he do that? Do you have are you worth anything over $20,000? Probably not. So you shouldn't even be.
Damn, that's cool.
Yeah.
It's the truth, though.
That's 725, 20 hours right there. Good.
Yeah. It's the truth, though. It's the truth. Most of the people that are rambling about what's going on and what the people in different tax brackets are doing, you can't even step foot in a room with these people.
No.
Like, they'll eat you up and chew you out. Like, you need to just do your due diligence as a civilian.
Come on,
do what you got to do to.
Dude, come on, Sterling.
Due diligence.
Use it in a sentence.
As a U.S. citizen or a citizen of Texas, and going about your business, because you don't have control over everybody.
Right.
You don't.
Facts.
So
we just need
worry about yourself, and that's really all that you can do. Why? I don't know why people are so up in arms about what these millionaires, billionaires are doing with their vote.
Mm-hmm.
If they want to... If they want to go and support somebody, does that still take away from their body of work that they did? No.
Facts.
It just means that they have a different opinion than you. I don't understand that. And that's another thing.
I know why people are like that, though. And I'm one of them. I understand. On one aspect that they do belong to a different tax bracket, right? So their views are completely economical. You know what I'm saying? That's just what it is, point blank period. It's about, you know, my taxes being raised. I don't want to pay that. I want to get, you know, tax breaks. I want to, you know, get corporate tax breaks if I can because of all these other different business ventures that I got going on. So I want that. Completely understandable. But when these black rappers, you know, who come from the slums and have obtained that type of wealth, right? You know what it's like to be where the people beneath you are. So, you know, at the end of the day, you can't forget where you come from no matter how much money that you've accumulated. Yes, you don't want to pay more in taxes, but at the end of the day, you should, bitch, because you're rich. That's just how it is. At the end of the day, you make more money, so you should pay more in taxes. It's that simple. Nothing else to it, really. I mean, at the end of the day, you just don't want to pay more in taxes. You want to keep more money for yourself and keep the same niggas that you came from. You want to keep them niggas down.
So and question, that is the not to cut you off, but just on that part, what about the people that take advantage of government assistance?
All of that shit. All of that shit, too. But right now, I'm just focusing on those rappers. We can get to the government assistance motherfuckers later. Right, you know what I'm saying? But just right now on those rappers, that's why people coming at y'all head, because it's like, yo, it's not about your economics, it's not about your pocket right now. At this point in time, like I told this white chick, man, earlier this week about this shit, it's like, yo, I get you might fuck with Trump but on other issues, but at the same time, like, the base that this nigga energizes, you know what I'm saying, and fuels, wants my black ass hung up in trees again to the point to where they get off scot-free. So at the end of the day, it's like, how can you vote for somebody, like, put economics to the side, how can you morally vote for somebody that continues to perpetuate their ideology? Like, it makes no sense to me. Fuck your pocketbook, my nigga. He wants your people strung up from fucking trees again, castrated, burned alive, for everybody to be able to see and get away with the shit. Like, if you see what's going on in America right now, like this week, like, it's police escorts that are carrying these Trump caravans. You know what I'm saying? Like, me and Carrie seen the shit going, you know what I'm saying, to brunch on Sunday. We saw a Trump caravan. You know what I'm saying? Like, straight up, like, this shit ain't no joke out here. So at the end of the day, it's like, yo, like, morally, I get it. You know what I'm saying? People, you know, have thrown morals and ethics out the fucking window when it comes to, like, you know, presidents or anything of that nature, because now every celebrity feels like they can run for president. But at the end of the day, it's like, yo, like, we got to get back to some type of morality and some type of astute, you know, prestige in the goddamn White House, bro. Like, at some point in time, like, you just do. So, I mean, that's why people are on these rappers' heads like that, because it's almost like they forgot where they came from. They forgot the bottom line. You know, it's not about your pocketbook right now, bro. It's about this, about your skin color, bro. That's all that matters right now. You know what I'm saying? We at war with that.
A lot of these niggas aren't even educated, and I can't do nothing but blame my own demographic about us putting that much energy into rappers, because it's like a lot of these niggas not even educated enough to give a strong opinion about who they feel like they want to vote for. So it comes to a point to a time where we got to start looking at our own community. Like, why we keep falling for the damn okie doke? Like, nigga, you looking at Wayne to be your advisor on who you should vote for, or what's going on for the Knicks, or is Flint about to get some water? Like, this.
Oh, them memes on Flint, bro. Niggas, because, you know, they voted, majority voted Trump, so niggas like, bro, I don't want to hear shit about water from you niggas, bro. I was like, oh, they come on
clean water. Oh, my God. Y'all niggas must not want clean water.
I was like, you know what? Don't even worry about this fresh Ozarka we got down here. You good? That's you right. Good up there?
I'm not finna indulge.
Well, they said the same thing about Texas and Georgia. They were saying, the next Florida. Time y'all mofos have a hurricane, don't ask for my assistance.
But we can't control that, though. That's kind of like out of our control.
Right. Nah, because if you look at the way the map was kind of plotted out,
yeah,
the major cities were blue. It's just these rural cities, these rural towns.
Which is, niggas don't understand. That's majority of Texas. So like,
especially Texas. And that's what I was saying with, you know, that's what Joe B was talking about earlier in the chat. Bro, in Texas, if it's not cattle, it's oil.
Facts.
And you got West Texas and you got Southeast Texas. You got your Port Arthur's, your Beaumont. Right now, because I guess, like, you know, I agree with Joe said earlier, there is going to be a time where oil is going to be, I ain't going to say obsolete, but we're going to have to slow it down and really work on natural resources.
Yeah. They're already doing that,
Yeah. Sure, but right now, they're not, you know, what Biden is standing for, they're not ready for that right now, especially with this pandemic and the oil industry already lost money.
Now, you got to clear it up. They're ready for it. They just don't want to.
Right.
Because it's a complete difference. They just don't want to because there isn't, oil isn't scarce as much as they say it is.
Like it's not the supply of it.
But they would rather, let's deteriorate this fucking planet as much as we can. You know what I'm saying? As much as we can get out of it. And you know we could go to natural energy, you know, for we're already light years ahead of that. We're playing for that. But no, we're going to keep digging and, you know, and taking our oil and doing what we need to do because that's just what we want to do. Fuck the planet. You know what I'm saying?
Captain Planet would be disappointed in us.
Man, what?
That nigga would be sick right now, bro.
But be honest, though.
We wouldn't even be able to call him.
Nah, we wouldn't. That nigga like, nah, bro. Flint, you definitely not getting my help.
No, yeah, for sure.
You niggas ain't getting no water. Water, get back in.
But be on the lookout, though. Texas could definitely go blue in 2024 because if you look at the landscape of everything.
It got kind
of
close.
It got really close.
It's really close.
People weren't expecting for it to go blue, to go blue for real, but the fact that it got close and the fact that it scared a lot of Republicans to let you know that a tide is changing as far as
stronger. We're stronger than we were for 8 years ago. Even when Obama was in office, we are way more informed than what we were. And first of all, when Obama first got into the office, like I don't even think we were able to vote.
Not the first time.
I would.
Yeah, not the first time.
That was my first time.
Yeah, yeah. You
were. No, I did say
you know, some people, you know.
Yeah, I'm sorry. We got.
Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Yeah. All right,
91 over here.
Everybody's
not 30, you know. Yeah, you know. The first time I wouldn't
name it, but
the second time, yeah. But you know, since then, you know, a lot of people have gained access to being able to vote. And we are not with the ish. It's not for it.
I have a question. You know, based off the map that of Texas, the counties, and we see that pretty much the only blue were your major cities.
Yep, pretty much.
Do you feel that the older we get, do you feel like that our generation is going to have to reach out and move out to these rural counties to help? No, not just us. I'm just saying, think about it. To help turn those red counties blue. Let them get it. You know, that's just a thought that just came in my head.
It's a mentality.
I don't
think it's gonna be that extreme.
I think
what'll happen next time is that the people just like there was more people that voted this time than 2016, I think it's gonna be greater the next term, and that's how we'll get more blue. I mean, people may move out and, you know, but I don't think it's going to become like an agenda. Like
I'm not saying that. Let's just say, you know, like,
no, with what
you know, with cattle and, you know, packaging meat plants and, you know, what if our, you know, they decided to take ownership. Now that's now you got a different demographic in power, you know, and you see what, not that I wanted to try to explain it before the reactions, but it's stuff. It's just like us. We, you know, we move from, I think most of us, if we're not from, you know, like your sunny sides and stuff like that. We moved to your Missouri cities. We moved to your parent lands. But just on a bigger scale. Yeah.
I get what you're talking about. Kind of branch out as more businesses.
Right. Because that does. I ain't going nowhere. I ain't going nowhere.
Like, the city is constantly expanding. You know what I'm saying? It's, I don't know. It's a lot of people moving into the city of Houston alone. So it's constantly expanding out. And, you know, more people are constantly, you know, kind of branching out to other cities around Houston. So possibly, yeah, I could see that possibly happening in the next 4 years. But honestly, man, I'm really I just want to see how this all turned out towards the end. And shout out to Obama hitting that nasty ass jumper.
He wet that mug and walked off with the smoothest
president we have ever had.
It looked like one take.
That was one take.
That's what I do.
The nigga had his mask on, hit the jumper, put his mask back on, got his coffee, and walked out. And I'm like, bro, you can't.
Hey, Jim, hold this real quick, Jim. Let me show you
something. This nigga hit the.
Hey, that's what I do.
Right. And it was wet, bro.
Didn't even break a sweat.
That's what I do. Put mask on, got coffee in hand. See you guys.
I wish he could go another term, bro. Just to bring the morale, back to our country, bro.
Obama was, I didn't really like a lot of his policies, but as a person, he was so likable. Like, you could not like him.
I think he was open and willing to figure things out. And that's the hard thing about the presidency that we got to understand. Like, one person can't do everything. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, even to answer your question, Devin, I feel like if people – I think we're kind of getting more to that. From this year, I got a vibe that people wasn't just looking at Democratic or Republican. They were looking at what's best for them. So if we start to go into that type of bag in these next coming elections in the future.
A lot of these red states to turn blue.
Yeah, because if these candidates are coming up, bringing making sense for these people in these agriculture and these warehouses and these all these type of industries where they look like they're getting left out. Once you start, you know, catering to their needs, then you'll kind of get the people to swing over and you'll find more swing states than what you had before. Because I do get a vibe that people now are just looking at which candidate is best serving me for what my needs are. Mm-hmm. And not just, oh, is it a Republican or Democrat? You know, so.
There he is.
Just from my vibe.
That's
what
he's like, oh, shit,
We
go again. I mean, that's what it should be. But to be honest with you, a lot of Democrats just be like, oh, vote straight Democratic, up and down the ticket. You know what I'm saying? And not even really knowing who. And we was kind of in that bag. I seen a couple names. I was any, mini, money, mo. And you know what I'm saying? And I was like, you know what? Go ahead and do the Democrat.
Well, I mean,
you know,
I put Democrat.
Ain't no C.
I put Democrats mostly because I was trying to really get us to flip the Senate, you know?
Yes.
But they didn't work?
Nope. It didn't work. Still got whole bitch ass. I figured that wasn't going to work. I mean, people just, which is crazy because, I mean, well, it's not crazy, but you got to think about it. Like, so Mitch McConnell represents Kentucky and the whole Breonna Taylor shit happened in Louisville. So it's like, you know, at the end of the day, it's like, yo, like, yeah, like that's not enough to get you motherfuckers out here to, you know, make sure that you change some things out. You know, really, 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 like, I need to see Kentucky, as far as black people are concerned, I need to see record numbers when it comes to voting locally, when it comes to their police station out there. You know what I'm saying? Like,
they got to talk about it, bro. They got to that has to be the conversation. They have to talk about it now. They have to keep the same energy. You know what I'm saying? Just like I said on the last podcast, let's not put all our energy into right now and then say, all right, okay, for the next
question. When are we going to, like, just hold ourselves accountable? Like,
I'm always talking about that.
Instead of having the conversation, yo, get your dumb ass, it's crazy, get your dumb ass out up there. You see what's going on. Like, nobody has to really show you or talk to you. You see what's going on. You know how to go out and change it, bro. Go do it, dog. Stop wanting a handout from people to tell you what to go do and how to go do it and how to go look up shit. I've had so many people, like, tell me, like during this whole election, bro, did you look at the debate? When they ask you, did you watch the debate? That means that they want you to tell them what the fuck happened. going and actually looking at the shit, bro. Like, no, my nigga, like, I'm not finna make it that easy for you, bro. Like, yo, we got to get to a point in time because, to be honest with you, it went black men voting for Trump went from 14% to 18% this election. Like, yeah. Why? You know what I'm saying? Like, what is it?
Finances.
Misinformation, right? Mm-hmm. Misinformation that you allow QAnon and all these other different, you know, fucked off ass sources, unreliable sources to kind of like fuck your mind up and tell you that, you know, this shit is real, this shit not. It's like, yo, dog, I'm not finna tell you over and over again to go do your own research and find out what's going on. You know what the fuck going on in your hood. You know what need to be changed in your hood. So you know how to get it changed. So go do it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's real simple, bro. I know in my hood what need to be, what looks bad, what doesn't look bad. So I know, hey, I need to vote on this because this affects this. I know that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's time for people to start holding ourselves accountable, bro. And yeah. Like, yo, take your own initiative. We can have a conversation, but you talking to a brick wall if said person doesn't want to, doesn't have the eagerness to learn themselves, right? So you got to put it on them to go put the groundwork in and go learn what the fuck you're supposed to be doing.
Man. Honestly, life is this whole politics stuff and voting, it's just like school. It's a class. Like, you can't always cheat. And then, you know, sometimes you're going to take that test and you're going to be by yourself. You know, you won't always have people to cheat off on. And so when it comes to like election and stuff, we're getting too old for to be relying on some. Well, I heard you heard. What did you read it? Like,
exactly.
What are we doing? Like, you need to have this concretely for yourself, because one thing about white folks, Asians, man, they gonna know which policies are gonna directly affect them. They're gonna know, and they're gonna take full, they're gonna go full-fledged toward it, full-fledged with it, if it fits them. I but think for some this- reason, we always have this, I need the information. Well, nobody told me that. Nobody told you. Like, come on, man. We getting too old for this.
We do that in everything, though, to be honest with you. I think,
but we got to stop people, that, though.
But black we people should. Keep to this. But this is always what I'm talking about, even with this election shit. We look for handouts from Trump. We look for handouts from Biden. But honestly, they not going to do shit that's going to affect us right now. We got to do it. You know what I mean? I'm always preaching that shit. We keep on talking about these candidates and we put all this shit on their back. But I feel like black people keep the same energy. We always like that. Mm-hmm. Tell me in what situation niggas ain't trying to go the fast route or hearing from so-and-so that so-and-so did this. We keep the same energy. It's a culture thing. It's a culture problem. And until the culture kind of gets to the core and putting them, holding each other accountable in everything, it's going to be the same thing with politics. Like, I mean, just to be honest with you, I wasn't really into politics at all a few years ago when I voted for Obama. Yeah. All right, bro, this nigga black. Let me go ahead and vote for the homie. He look good. I like how he's saying some of the things. He sound like he know what he's talking about. I wasn't into politics. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to sit here and act like I was just saying that whole, come on, we got to get these political parties correct and let's do this. You know what I'm saying? Like, nigga, I was chilling. You know what I'm saying? But now, you know, you getting into that space to where now you start to realize, okay, now I'm a working person now. Now I'm starting to make a little income. Okay, now this shit, now it's starting to matter to me. So now what we can do is not giving niggas a handout, but it's letting niggas know, like, hey, bro, in a couple of years, what you doing or what you seeing right now while you playing, this shit gonna matter. Because right now it don't matter to you. You making $7.50 an hour is not really bothering you because you ain't really financially there yet. But when you start to make the moves and you start thinking about, man, I'm trying to buy a house. Why are these banks tripping on me? Trying to get a car. Why these banks, you know what I'm saying? Like, you start to see how these things affect you once you get out there. And that's if you don't have the upbringing or a family that's educationally sound to help you kind of get to them steps before you get older. Because not everybody have those parents that's aware or financially knowledgeable to kind of set you up before you get out of college or stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, most of our parents were old school and seen black and white water fountains. So they was just thankful just to be able to vote and just to be able to be in the conversation. And I don't look at it per se as a – I look at it as a culture problem, but I also look at it as is nothing wrong with us reaching back, you know what I'm saying, and showing the young, you know, the person next to come who's not in that status yet, hey, look out, you know what I'm saying, because – and not everybody going to take heed to it, let's be real. But it's going to be a nigga who going to be like, you know what? That nigga owning something. He look like he doing well for himself. He not flashy. He seemed like he got a nice, wholesome, consistent lifestyle. Hold on, I might, hey bro, let me get some knowledge from him. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's where them things come from. But if we just put everybody in a box and be like, nah, nigga, go look at it on your own. Go, it's like niggas going, it's gonna keep going on the same way. We can't expect shit different to happen if we keep thinking and doing the same shit the same way.
I wish, because I know that's what me. Oh, my bad. Okay.
I look at it like this. So, when you were in class, right, or you're taking an AP class or whatever, or just a regular class.
Thank you, because I wasn't AP, right? So.
Yeah, we know.
I see in my class.
We know.
Okay.
if you were in class and you're about to be tested on something, you can't raise your hand and ask the teacher, hey, what's the answer to number 3? She gonna look at you like you going a penis out your forehead, because what should you have done? You should have studied and you would have known the answer,
right?
But there are part, like, if you fail the test, you can go to tutorial. That's how I look at it. Like, I feel
it's
like
not, there's no tutorial in real life. You going your ass to jail, you sitting out for 10 years.
Well, we ain't talking about nothing illegal. We talking about voting. So we gonna keep it on the instances of voting, because that's what we're talking about.
Okay.
I feel as if when it comes to certain things, yeah, you can reach out and help somebody. I also don't feel like Joe was saying this either. I personally wasn't saying, oh, in every situation, if you don't know,
Y'all were saying.
Yeah, I know. I'm just clarifying. Like, there are certain instances where you're gonna have to stand on your own sometime, and our community has this, like, this feeling of, well, if they don't tell me, then I'm just not gonna know, or it's not my fault that I don't know because I wasn't told. Like, that needs to cut out, and like, period. If it's somebody who's, like, significantly younger than me and literally doesn't have a clue as to what they're talking about or what they need to look for, I have no problem with right. like, sparing knowledge and taking time out to show them A, B, and C. You know what I mean? So they won't fall into traps. But you are 40, 30, I'm in my 20s, and you trying to debate with me on something that you have no knowledge of, on something that you heard. Now, not only is that an issue, but that's how you also spread misinformation. So to stop that, to alleviate all of that, everybody, but specifically the Black community, because that's what we're talking about, they need to be, you know, well-versed in these types of things. Not saying that you need to know every single, how the Electoral College is picked, how they formed, like, not saying you need to know all of that, but you need to have the gist of what's going on, so you'll be able to, you know, to learn more, to add to what you already know.
So you
know, it's not going to be something that you learn in one sitting, but, you know, make a conscious effort so you won't be putting your misinformation on someone else. Well, that's not what I was told.
Right.
I just wish we can really go ahead and do real research. That's what irked me, you know, the most. It's like we, I think everybody said it is. So what happened? Or you go on social media and you're only going to see 15 seconds of what they want you to see.
Right.
How about you take, because I know on my phone, I got CNN, MSNBC, I got the Wall Street Journal. I'm doing my research. It might be times instead of watching, you know, BET, I'm watching C-SPAN. I want to know what the House and the Senate is discussing, what they're voting on, because it's not just about the president. It's not just on a federal level that gets affected, but also on a state and a local level. We need to know these things. We need to know what we're voting for. You know, you get mad, you know, back, you know, like early 2010s when they had the red light cameras. Who knew that we had to vote on those things? When I found that out, I said, oh, I can't wait to go vote because I'm voting no because I had got a ticket like 2 weeks before that about the red light cameras. So, you know, it's just small stuff that we complain about. It's the small stuff. Yeah, well, it's the small stuff. And it is worse when they send you a video of you running a light. That's just
you, this is definitely you.
This yeah, is you. Yeah, that's me.
I know that Impala but with that illegal tint.
Look at you on this weak ass Buick.
But it's the small stuff that we complain about. That mm-hmm. all we have to do is go and vote yes or no.
Or no.
But you know what I've seen the most yesterday? Funniest shit ever. Niggas that was like, man, fuck that voting shit. I ain't with the voting, but the same niggas like, hey, who winning that hoe? Dude, what does it matter?
Yeah, who better? Doesn't matter to you.
Like, that was the funniest shit yesterday I seen, bro. It's crazy.
That's crazy, true. Crazy. I have a question though. Who do y'all think people generally get their interest in politics and stuff like that? Do y'all think they learn most of it, or for people that are into it, from home, or do you think from school?
It's not from school, because they're not teaching that in high school. Mm-hmm. And depending on what college you go to and what kind of situation you learn from that, you may learn it there. But I think what it is more so than anything, and I'm really learning this right now, it really kind of hit me through this whole election process, watching how some of my classmates from high school, you know, go back and forth about certain things. It's like, yo, it's getting to a point to where, like, you grow up and you like, yo, it's lame to not know how this country works. You know what I'm saying? It's like, no longer is it, like, cool to not know how this country works. It's actually super lame.
But that's like, what I'm trying to figure out. Like, do you think, like, a lot of the people that are invested into, like, knowing and the knowledge and wealth, do you think a lot of them kind of had that, they watched that growing up, and it was kind of like pretty much they was getting like a full view growing up, and it kind of made them tap into it on their own? Or do you think
it could be anything. Like, you could be anything. Yeah, it could be anything.
It can also be an experience that you have too, and you like, you know what, I don't want to go through that again, so let me figure out how not to. Right. Or like Devin, like, he, you know, the whole camera light situation, he got a ticket, and next thing you know, he's voting against it. Why? Devin, because we have to learn through that.
Devin ran that light. He just
and it was messed up too, because it was like yellow red turn.
Nah, man. We don't want to hear it.
You ran that light, bro.
This guy trying to get that, man. Cool, anyway. Bro.
What you saying? I ain't gonna see you at the gym.
We been there, bro.
Right, but you know. Kind of like what, you know, what Joe said. I know, like, with me, when I was little, I was interested. I had a lot of interest in government. And, you know, and so, like, even I think the first president race we could think about is Gore and Bush.
Yep.
I know, you know, we were like 9 or 10.
Elementary, like in the third grade I was.
Yeah. And I remember looking at my research and some of those words. I'm 10 years old, so a lot of words I really couldn't understand, but I was reading and trying to get an understanding, and then I go to school and want to talk about it. Like, I'm voting for Gore because he's Democrat. Well, I can't really have a discussion with you because that's all you know. Like, what, you know, what do you know? And then it went from Bush into was it John Kerry, and then, you know, did our research on that. And that was like my first. That was like my first election. I was like, this is tough. And then Bush got in office, and then he just made things worse. Then I was like, okay, now it's time to make a change. And like, I was upset that I couldn't vote for Obama because I was 17 at the time, you know, but I always did my research. And even on Congress level, you know, Congress level, shut up. And, you know, on the Senate level, and then also your governors, because really, to me, when it comes to our class, the president ain't talking to us. Now, governors and our city councils, our mayors, that's who speak to us. You know, the president have power, but the governor the governor runs the state. Let's just call it what it is.
Be careful how you say that, though, how you word that, though, Devin, because when you say the president has power, but the niggas be, see, he ain't really got that much.
It don't even matter.
You gotta be careful.
But that instead of people just listening off edge, they need to go know why he only have so much. Let's see. That goes back to what we've been talking about. Let's do our research.
Facts.
Yeah, bro. It's tough, bro. This is a tough conversation.
Let me look at the stats. Let me see.
What you
here we go. Let's go. Pull up the numbers.
What you digging up?
Me going.
The double.
If Biden gets Nevada, it's over. Trump gonna take his ball and go home.
See what we got.
Did he finally get Michigan? Oh, he did get Michigan.
Michigan and Wisconsin. Ooh, I don't know. I hope we do get Nevada, but right now we at Donnie T. Dumpster T is at 48.7.
Dumpster T.
Dumpster T.
And which state?
T and that's Nevada. Mm. And then Joe and Biden is 49.3. They are literally a point and 3/4 away from each other.
Damn.
Yeah. I think they say they still have a lot of votes in Clark County.
Force. Huh?
I know it was in Clark County in Nevada. That's what that's what they're worried about right now. They still getting a lot of those mail-in ballots.
580,605. Joe got 588,000.
This is crazy.
It looks like Biden's still at 253 and Trump at 213. I mean, they just feel like it's kind of hard for him to catch all them
states. Biden's at 264.
Yeah,
he's at 264. All he needs is
six more.
Is Nevada.
Oh, they 253 on CNN.
Yeah, no, it keep updating on these other apps.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because y'all had CNN open too.
So all he needs is six. So really all he needs is Nevada.
Is Nevada. That's it. That's it.
Nevada. That's why the memes are coming out like, Nevada, what you doing? That's why the memes is
and
out.
And then right them niggas like, they
hands are
tomorrow.
Bleeding.
Oh, bro.
They gonna wait till tomorrow. They're not gonna finish it tonight.
No. Unrelated, bro. Something's going on with Arby's, dog. Something's going on with these niggas, bro. Because they just purchased Arby's. They just purchased Dunkin' Donuts and Baskin Robbins.
I told you, bro. Y'all been
Arby's, bro. They got to be
fucking with Arby's.
Bro, they got to have
niggas in business.
Yo, bro, them niggas is laundering money, bro. I don't care what nobody says. That is a
bro. Fun. They in the sex trafficking too. If that's the case, there ain't no way.
They Dunkin' Donuts and Baskin Robbins
purchasing Dunkin' and Baskin Robbins, bro.
They finna come out with an all meat donut ice cream burger.
Oh, it's funny.
Are you gonna hear Big Rays? Are you hungry with dessert? Here they go.
Nigga said with dessert. It's funny because I don't go to none of them places. All them places I see, I pass up.
I like marble slab.
I pass up. Them niggas they cooking crystal meth. They got to be cooking crystal meth. They
got
to be
doing meth lab.
Yes, they have. They only want Walter White.
Yeah, they only want Walter White. Breaking Bad.
Yeah, Walter White.
Walter.
They only want Walter White shit. Bro, because there's no line at who. I mean, I've been to Arby's. They got some good stuff, but every time I go, there's no line. So I'll be trying to figure out. Where are you getting this money from?
Who eating it?
Yes, who's eating that Arby's?
I don't know nobody. I mean, every now and then when I drive by the Arby's, I may see one or two cars.
That's what I'm saying.
What if it's like, what if it's,
I ain't
what
if it's fish like, sandwich hard though?
Yeah, that food is pretty good.
So it's what you.
So what if it's like?
Remember,
how
I told
like,
you about that on Good Friday. The time I ain't know what to eat, and I went and got a little fish sandwich. at Arby's because I got a Sonic. I was at Sonic getting a slush because it was like 3 o'clock. And then I was like, you know what? I don't know what to eat. I can't eat nothing at Sonic. So let me go ahead. It was Arby's right across the street looking lonely. So we went over there.
You looking
all
lonely.
You think they're lonely. Them niggas is cooking up shit.
Hey, that shit was fire, though.
Fish fillets.
But hey, let's
a customer.
But we got company.
Think about it like this. Kind of like, so you see the major cities. Mm-hmm. Or blue and rural red. Mm-hmm. We know nobody that we know just, you know, goes to Arby's. What if it's like the Arby's in these rural towns is just getting
that could possibly be that
just
could
getting
be
all the business looking like Frenchies in Third Ward, you know, every day.
I mean, possibly. That's true, bro. Like some of these restaurants are more popular in other states. You know,
Arby's
we all see it, dog.
Arby's
we all know, like to us, Arby's is like an I guess like place. Hey, y'all want Arby's? I guess.
RB, nobody even say that.
Nobody
says that.
Arby's is at every truck stop.
That makes sense.
When you're passing through like Lincoln or any of these other like rural areas, like they're there. Like, you know what I'm saying? Next to a Love's, like you said. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, they
all
there. That's what
they
doing.
They know what they're doing. Hey, and I told y'all, I'm telling you, other states, they doing something because I want to say it was in Mississippi. They still got Fruitopia on the McDonald's as an option. So some of these places got some secrets to the reason why they still.
This niggas bought them niggas for $11 billion like it was chump change. Here you go. Give me that shit. It's mine now. Like,
oh, wait, $11 billion?
$11 billion.
No.
Who bought that?
Arby's. $11 billion.
Say that COVID money.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
$11 billion.
Yes, $11 billion.
They got that much money from Lunch Me?
Yes, I don't know what's going on.
Euros.
I think I'm speaking too much, bro.
Hey, get off Arby's, bro. Let Arby's make it.
This is off topic. We probably need to have this conversation on another show. But speaking of selling shit and catalogs and stuff, let's talk. We have to talk about what's going on. All of these different music moguls and producers and things of that nature are selling their catalogs off or whatever. Calvin Harris just sold his entire catalog this far for $100 million. Yeah, Rodney Jerkins just sold it. That's it. What you mean?
But I'm saying Calvin Harris is worth way more than that.
Yeah,
you know, $100
million. Calvin Harris is like one of the biggest EDM DJs out there.
Hey,
he is, but you gotta think about it.
It's a different time, like, bro.
It's not even just the money. Start doing other music.
Yeah, because they're
I'm saying it's
nobody
the money
had
that,
a music festival.
It's the money he's already created from his catalog, right? Mm-hmm. So it's not even including that. So the money he's already generated from his catalog, on top of the $100 million that he sold for the catalog, and then he's a creative, so he can create endless amounts of whatever the fuck he wants to create. So that nigga's winning right now to me.
He really is.
Selling your catalog for $100 million. But reason why I say it's a topic that we could discuss is because Rodney Jerkins has sold his which is L.A. Reid just sold his. So his entire catalog.
Really?
Yeah. And I don't know how much, but I know it's for a fucking pretty penny. Like, I know it's way more than Calvin Harris.
There you go. Get the Googles. Get them Googles popping. Ross already in the Googles.
Facts.
So do you think they're doing this because you got to think about it. There hasn't been any concerts, any festivals. Is it because of the unforeseen circumstances now? Or do you feel like that's just another journey they're trying to go on and get a catalog, sell it?
Yeah, for them probably.
Because it wasn't Ultra Fest. It wasn't it wasn't no Austin City Limits. Any of these festivals.
It wasn't It wasn't no heads up that this was going to happen. Mm-hmm. So because I was listening to Chris Rock do an interview and he was saying, like, to be honest with you, it's a lot of his celebrity friends that call him that don't got money right now. Like, a lot of celebrity
people. $650 million.
Woo!
That's a nice penny.
That's nice.
You sure it wasn't $650,000?
Let me borrow $5 million. Let me have $5 million.
L.A. Reid sells 100% of his 160 song writing and publishing catalog.
100%? Damn.
All of it.
Well, he did his job. So now he's older. He just chill now. But, you know, I'm trying to get on that Jeff Bezos type money. Trying to figure out. What the hell?
Oh, no. Nah, you
trying to get on that art
money? That's the scary money, though.
Boy, that's the triangle money.
Well, frighten me because I want.
Boo, nigga.
$6 billion. $6 billion.
To the Bermuda
Keep
triangle.
Doing it. I'll take it, bro.
That's when you meet the CEO of Arby's. Yeah, you didn't know I was in here, huh?
Oh.
Wait, what the fuck?
That nigga's an alien, dog. The Men in Black got
gotta be something worth $11 billion. So more than that, if he got $11 billion, just
who said $11 billion? Oh, I'm talking about Jeff, bro. We talking about we in the triplets with the billion,
man. If
you
in
Jeff Bezos worth like 300 some odd billion,
and it's increasing.
Yeah.
He keep breaking his own record, bro.
Wait, who?
Jeff Bezos, Amazon guy.
Yeah.
He ended up rich.
Scary money. Yeah, you wouldn't even know what to do with that amount of money.
Bro. I would.
You just
and Amazon is just steady growing, man.
I know the world. Yeah,
oh, like, and how they doing food and stuff too.
Yeah, like, food delivery. Yeah.
So hey, that's the thing. That's another few billion.
Thing. With that type of money, man, you start trying to make some changes, man. Boys start having issues with you trying to make changes.
I knew that Amazon.
I guarantee you, he already in that little clique. He's already there. Him, the Facebook founder, Mark creator, Zuckerberg. Instagram. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's just crazy how he got big. It's like eBay is obsolete.
I mean, people
don't know
still
anybody
use
who
eBay,
shops on eBay no more.
Yeah. You might sell stuff like collectibles and memorabilia, but as far as I'm scared,
eBay is like Arby's.
You can put some Air Force Ones. Yeah.
Nah, eBay still going. It's just I don't know. I can't do eBay. I got trust issues. So
it don't even give you a direct time. Maybe 2 weeks from now, sir. I'm gonna need my items tomorrow.
Nigga, when we ship it, that's when you gonna get.
That's when you gonna get it. Okay. You get it when I send it. That's the option for your delivery.
I used to, as soon honestly, as I buy something, I used to message when you ship this. Like, I need to know. I need a tracking number.
Like, damn, dude, the payment didn't even go through yet. Make sure
it don't matter. It's good.
Yes, it did. It's good on my end. It just went through. Check your bank account, brother.
But I mean, just like you was saying, Devin, bro, it's really a lot of money out there. You know what I'm saying? Like,
it is.
I wish we could speak to like a financial person, coach, advisor, whatever. I mean, it's so many ways of different streams of revenue. But like I was saying before the pod, I feel like a lot of people are just so one-dimensional. You know, we got one ticket. It's just going to be this. That's the only way I can make it. It's like niggas out here making money for all kind of shit. Buttons on the shirt. Mm-hmm. Like, when are you telling me you can make money just for the most simplest things? They should really open more people up to be like, you know what, it's different ways to get it. I don't have to necessarily follow this person's exact plan. I don't gotta always pick up a basketball or a football. You know what I'm saying? It's plenty of different opportunities. And, you know, if something matters to me and politics is schooling, what we teaching in school, because I feel like those years are really important, especially early on, kind of putting kids on to what different possibilities are of things that they can get into. You know, when I didn't find out until high school about the gaming where you were coding and stuff like that. We kind of touched on that a little bit in high school towards the end of my, I think I was like a junior or something, but like, had I known about that before, like in middle school or my freshman year, I would have been like, bro, this probably would have been something I would have went all the way in on, you know what I'm saying? So, I do wish one day we can get to a point to where more, schools in our communities where we come from have those options to show you different things outside of just always having to hoop or play football or be in a band. It could actually be things that you can get interested in that you probably never know you was good at that'll make you a millionaire.
That's why I said, you know, before everybody came on, I can't be stagnant. I want to learn. And once I feel like I've learned it, all right, I got my groove in this. What's next? What's next? And that's why I like the back end stuff. Like, now, you know, I've mastered, you know, audio. Now I want to learn photography. And once photography is done, let's get the editing. Once the editing is done, you know, and then you a self-taught producer.
Mm-hmm.
Talk your shit, King.
Facts.
I'm just being real.
My path, exactly, bro. That's exactly what I was on. Like, that's the same. It's just, it is one thing about being a creative, and it's one thing about owning it and being able to kind of control the show from behind the scenes and help other people get to that place, you know. But, you know, as a community, bro, we just continue to, honestly, here on earth, show love towards one another, stop doing things out of spite or trying to put something over your head like, oh, I taught that nigga that. I gave him that $50. He don't. I'm the reason why he got this. It's like,
oh my god!
If we stop doing that, bro, I promise you, I think the community will be a better place. And I feel like, you know, it'll be easier during these revelation times we're living in to cope with one another. You know, because it's really all about love, bro. It's time for us to wake up and stop fighting over Birkin bags and shit, and who can afford it, and just help.
Don't get me started.
Hey, we got on that last time, but you know, I had to throw that in there because I was just saying that. I don't know who I was talking to, but I was like, bro, here we are fighting about this, and that's when the voting and the stuff was going on, and different things in the political parties was happening, and we was debating about who can afford a Birkin, if it's real or not. And I'm like, bro, look, we just blind. Like, you can put a nuke in the air right now. We're going to be like, bro, there ain't no real deal. You ain't no real, like, what does it care, bro? We're not going to be here in 2 seconds. Fake or real Jordan, it don't matter.
You stupid.
It don't. Like, and I'm a Nat Geo person, so I'm learning a lot about different cultures and stuff like that. And you seeing, bro, some of these people don't have no idea the shit we got, and they be living their best life. I'm talking best about life. Going life to the fucking fullest, bro. They ain't worrying about cell phones. Who talking to who, baby daddy on Instagram? Who got caught with who? I mean, they really just living naturally, fucking in the wild, sleeping on hammocks. Like,
so this was life. This was a question I asked ahead earlier.
Yeah.
Why are we so caught up in other people's lives instead of focusing on our own life?
Because we like a lot of people like to escape. That's their escape. They like to, you know what I'm saying, either A, see somebody go through some shit that's worse than them so they can revel in it, or B, be envious of somebody of their situation and just fantasize, damn, I wish that was me. Or C, try to find some truth into somebody's life and try to compare it to them.
You in your bag right now. Wait a minute.
We can go down all the way to Z. We can go all the way to Z.
How you really feel, Ross? So what's going on in your life?
You always got utensils, Devin. Like, last time it was the gloves.
I had this thing all the time, man.
Devin always got shit in hand. He got props. Hey, he got props
ready,
waiting.
So I ain't
got
to get ready. Come on now.
Oh, 100. I'm tweeting that tomorrow, bro. So be on the lookout for that.
All right.
Man, you can go down the list, bro. People use social media primarily, you know. Not everybody, but a lot of people that you see commenting stuff and really going back and forth with other people on somebody else's life is clearly that it's not much going on in their life, and they use this as an escape to, you know, feel validated by their points or whatever they see. So that's really what it mostly come down to, man.
Talk your shit, King.
You stupid.
Okay, well, what's up with you and this King stuff?
Hey, I'm bigging my kings up, queen.
Hey, I'm with it.
Bruh, I'm with it. The funniest shit, bro. Oh my God, Cardi B, she divorced the Offset. She finally know her worth. Then a month later, she back with the nigga.
She back with him.
Like, mind your goddamn business.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Thank you.
Out here looking stupid while she over there hugging up on her cheap nigga.
Because we really don't know what's really going on.
Hey, that's honestly, what I be saying.
Yeah, that's their relationship. That's their marriage.
That's what I be Focus saying about on people. People
but you. Okay? I will say, these people make it so easy for you just to be like, have your opinion, because they put it out there. Cardi got on here and made a full production on how she tied to him. Is she tired of being treated like A, B, and C? Culture, I'm going to protect my daughter at all costs. And then 2 weeks later, you talking about...
You know what? That's so true. And that's why I'm always big on, be mindful of your influence. Be very mindful of your influence. And I talk about that a lot, bro. Because whatever influence you have, it's some kid. I mean, you got to think, bro. We didn't grow up on Instagram. So we can't really talk in a place how it feels to grow up. Seeing our celebrities back in the day was big because you wasn't
seeing much
close to them. You know what I'm saying? You feel so close to them being on social media and with them every day. But you know, for people who got an influence, bro, you got to be very mindful and careful, because you could be teaching something to a child that may feel like how you doing things is the way. You know what I'm saying? Like, if they look up to you so much, seeing you do certain things, they were, oh man, I need to have this.
That's how it's supposed to be.
I gotta have this. I mean, it's like, again, you have to be careful though. It's who is the influencer, because if I'm promoting a bunch of material shit, then I'm telling you, hey, this is what success is. This is what success is in life. Mm-hmm. All this shit that I got. Look at this new Beamer. You can have this. This is gonna make you
happy. Sounding like that infomercial at the beginning of every YouTube video.
Yeah, bro.
You're probably wondering how I got this.
They got like 8 Lamborghinis in the back and shit, and it's like, nigga, fuck you and them rentals. Like,
you know, it's crazy. I actually spoke on this in my last Bible class that I taught.
Come through, bitch.
Like 2 months ago, and Ecclesiastes 2. You know, David, he wanted to know how I feel. I'm being dead serious. He wanted to know how to feel to have these things to go out, and at the end of the day, you know, he didn't feel the way he was. You know, he was still not happy. So, even though we see people buying these things and having this and having that, and you know, like you say, your influence, and I spoke on that before too. In our mind, they're happy. So I want to be happy. So I'm gonna save. I'm gonna hustle. I'm gonna fight and do what I have to do to get that Beamer so I can be happy. Now you got a Beamer. Now guess what? 3 months. It's time for oil change. Do you got $1,200 for oil change? Don't worry. I'll wait. You have electrical issues because you have a car that's mostly computerized with computer technology. Do you have $2,000 to fix that?
Them sensors ain't
that's cheap. Why he ain't happy because he going through maintenance.
This nigga say
he going that nigga say he ain't happy because he going through maintenance.
This nigga said $1,200 oil change.
People ask me, why you don't get no Lexus? Because I love my Chevy. Anything else?
Like, why you don't get no Lexus?
Yeah, I'm like, I don't like Lexuses. I don't like Chevys.
I mean, bro, we conditioned to feel like that's what making it is, you know what I'm saying? Even especially when we grew up, like just seeing all your favorite celebrities with the spinners. Man, I want a spinner so bad. I had them in my shoes, you know. Let's roll past that though. But,
let's roll past that.
What was the colorway worn?
Huh? They was all white,
all white.
Oh, they match with everything.
Oh, when you walked in and spin, or did you have the ones that you had to spin it?
Nah,
some of them the spin was nuts.
I ain't do the work.
Sometimes it'll get stuck.
You had the real God eyes.
It was natural. Mine's natural. They spin on their own. But now, yeah, it got to the point so bad because, you know, Escalades was a big thing. That's when niggas had it on their chain and the rims and all that. So it's like, you like, bro, damn, I want to. So you conditioned to feel like that's what success is. But reality hit your ass real quick. When you get your first job, it's like, to me, I wasn't buying Jordans as much as I would have wished I would have when I start working. Because now you busting your ass at these 5 to 8 hours at this little part-time job. And when you get your first check, you're like, man, what the hell is this? What is taxes? What is federal? Mm-hmm. What is social? What? All this shit. I don't need help. What? And then next thing you know, you got just enough to get the Jordans.
That's it. Now you broke.
We're eating all the rest of the week. So
yeah,
priority set in, and that's what
I'm saying. Joe, since you brought up the Jordan situation, I don't know if Joe remember this, but we went to get the metallic fives. I forgot what mall we went to, and a nigga in line was talking about, "She, we ain't gonna have no lights and food, but we gonna have these Jordans."
Yep, I remember, and I remember everybody was like,
"What?
was it a joke?"
No, I don't think he was.
So I always want to ask. I always want to ask somebody that really was true on that. Why is shoes that's going to be worn out in 6 months to 2 years, depending on how long you wear that shoe?
Because I gotta have these whole. I gotta look good for the hoes.
So
I gotta have
this nigga sick. And he got a family, bro.
Oh, I'm glad you brought that up because I was hoping somebody respond like that. Why do we have that mindset?
Oh my God.
It's a status symbol. Mm-hmm. It's like if you got J's, it automatically, like in a lot of hood niggas' mind, it puts you in a certain
broke nigga mentality. Like,
it is. But that's just what it is. Like, that's why I say hood niggas, like, oh, you got J's? Like, cool. Like, that's a status symbol. Like,
hole in your niggas, drawers.
I could have, I'm gonna tell you this crazy shit. So, like, I'm not gonna put no names out there of where we were at, but we was at one of our friends' houses for a New Year's Eve party. And
you saying a lot of particulars,
right? Right.
Hold on, Joe.
So, here's the thing. We had to take our shoes off at the front door.
Bro,
garbage. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure this person know you talking about them now. But go ahead, take us to the next.
Nah, they don't.
Drop a name.
They definitely don't.
But here's the thing.
Look at Devin.
Some shoes wind up getting stolen. But the shoes that got stolen wasn't even the most expensive shoes there.
Mm-mm. It wasn't.
But because the shoes that were stolen were Jay's.
Had that Jumpman on it.
It was gone. But I'm like, when we looked up, it was like, they ain't even steal it. Never mind. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what kind of bum ass friend do you have that come to your shindig and steal at the party you invited them to?
We not only steal. First of all, I got to get into the store. We're not going to get into it. The purpose is saying it was some other shoes that niggas wasn't even thinking about.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, yo, these cost way more than them Jordans, but because they're Jordans, you took those.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's a status symbol. It's just how it is. And Jordan gonna continue to make money because of the nostalgia, you know.
He already imprinted that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think what it is it's more so people are more infatuated with Jordan the brand than they are Jordan, the actual player. Because Jordan, the actual player, was good, but you got to think about it. Like, the majority of niggas that watch basketball, like, now the young niggas coming up, they never even watch. The only time they've seen Jordan is through the Last Dance documentary and YouTube. They never actually watched this nigga play, you know, in a real-life game.
That's enough.
Like, you had to see that nigga play, like, you know, to really understand how great that individual was. That's why we can't fathom how great Bill Russell or Wilt Chamberlain was, because we weren't actually watching them in real time do what they were doing and what the landscape of it was. So it's like niggas are more prone to the brand of Jordan. Like, nigga, the mystique of Michael Jordan is so infatuating, impactful. It's like, his shoes are always gonna sell. Them hoes gonna come out 11 times over, but you gonna buy them.
How many times them damn breads came out? They just brought them back out last year. Y'all gotta be honest.
When he came out with his shoes though in sports, them hoes looked like the best athlete shoe of his time. Like,
for sure, for sure.
And they look dope too.
But the funniest thing about it is they look dope. But once they figured out that, yo, the quality that we make them for Jordan to play in, we not finna make them with the quality for these niggas to walk around in.
Of course not.
So at the end of the day, it's like, yo, you not really, them hoes still gonna be okay quality. Well, now it's not, you know, in the 90s when they were first coming out, or they were like retro, maybe like one time or twice or whatever. Like, okay, cool. But like now, like, hell no. The material and
them
quality.
Them hoes get made in a sweatshop.
Straight up.
Straight facts, bro. Them hoes get made for $2.50. I'm not even joking, bro. And they get all the major profit.
Is inflate them hoes on websites like Stock Exchange. Mm-hmm. Like, you gonna pay retail like $170, some $200, but you gonna pay damn near $1,000 for a new release that come out, or a Christmas release or whatever, or some breads, because they know niggas gonna buy them for $1,000.
You got the breads, but you don't got no bread.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That was all.
I only own one pair of Jordans in my whole life.
Breads, but ain't got no bread to eat.
Like,
that's funny, bro.
I'm tweeting that tomorrow.
You
bro.
Got the bread, but you ain't got no bread to eat, dog. Probably.
No, he was saying you got the breads, but you don't got no bread. Like, you ain't got no bread.
You rather spend $250 on some breads instead of buying $1.50 for some bread.
That's what. Hey, people's priority, or it's now.
When it's on sale.
Now it's not even that. It's the designer, the Gucci boats, you know, the Balenciaga boats, like all the colorful designer shoes, you know what I'm saying?
A brand that don't give a fuck about you.
Yeah, spend $600 for $600 to $1,200 for a shirt, maybe some shoes, you know what I'm saying, some jeans or whatever. You spend about $2,000 on one fit to go out for one night to potentially maybe get some action. And then you probably spending some money while you going out.
Or you like, don't get no ass. You just look fly. There's a lot of niggas. Look fly. It's a lot of fly, no ass getting niggas out here. And
you know what? I'm flip flopped on that because I understand, like, is a dude that like to dress well. Like, you know, at the end of the day, like,
nah, nigga, I don't understand. You don't got the money. Like,
if you don't got the money, if you don't got the money, yeah, but that's our problem. Like, I understand, like, buying designer shit. Like, it's nothing. If you got the money to go to, you know, Saks and get you a fucking Ferragamo, you know, belt or whatever, you know what I'm saying, to go with your fit, that's cool. Like, if you want to go get a Ferragamo belt and you want to rock that, that's what you rock. Or you want to get you some Gucci, whatever, you know, it's cool. But, like, make sure you doing that and you got the means to pay for it. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't just do that shit when you got, you know.
That's a big, I mean, because people actually collect things that are expensive. So I never have a problem. I mean, bro, if you want to go spend $2,000 on a Pokemon card, what they was doing spending
$200,000? It's your money.
That. But a lot of these niggas doing that got that money and it's a tax write-off of them. That's another thing niggas ain't knowing.
I just don't like when niggas don't know that
you can write this stuff off.
They don't know. Half of these niggas writing that off.
I don't like when niggas wear certain shit. Like, yo, stop fucking wearing that goddamn Ferragamo belt with them fucking Jordans, dog. That shit is fucking silly. Like, I hate
it's,
that
it's
shit.
It's classless.
Or them Balenciaga. On them ugly ass Balenciaga shoes, bro. That look like it's two shoe bottoms on top of a shoe. It's like this shit.
New gen elevator shoes.
Nigga, you be 5'4" and you be 5'11" when you put them shoes on. Like, bro, come on, man. Take that shit off, bro. It ain't even live.
Yeah, that's really what it is.
Niggas really be out here zooming in on the brand name and shit. Like, bro, you look like a stupid. Them the new coons. this the new coon era. But now, this is a dope podcast, bro. I think
he said the new coon era.
The new coon.
It is. It's
the old new coon order. What's
that? Age of a coon.
The age of the
NWO. Age of the coon.
I mean, we just got to get our shit together mentally, bro. Again, at the end of the day, bro, people just got to learn how to come together, have priorities, have your shit straight. I feel like if you got a Mercedes Benz and you pulling up to a house that you living in on housing, it don't make sense. Like, it's just a lot of priorities that people, you know, that's a different bag I want to get into next podcast because we wasn't able to touch on it.
Oh, God.
all the government assistant people who floss on the people who's actually working and got to pay for health care and they got to pay for child care and they got to pay for food. It's so much that the middle class and the working class people have to go through. You know what I'm saying? And those really be the heart of the vote because those are the ones that actually get fucked up on both sides. Like, nigga, I ain't poor enough to get housing, but I make too much.
I make too much to get health care.
Yeah, like really? What sense does that make? Nigga, I need help.
I gotta choose? I gotta either work at McDonald's and live in a nice neighborhood? God.
So I gotta leave my career and work for $7.25 for only 20 hours a week?
Don't want your children to go to a good school.
The name of next week's episode should be "It Gotta Match." The house gotta match with the car. The ass gotta match with the thighs. If it don't match your lifestyle. It gotta match.
It's a lot. Your neck gotta match your face when you put makeup on or the highlights.
It gotta match.
This ain't making sense.
Gotta match.
Some of y'all women be out there. Y'all be having them fucking ant built ass booties and shit with them old skinny ass thighs and shit. And shit don't match, sweetheart. I'm sorry.
I'll see you in 40 years. See how dumb your ass look when that shit still
looking
popped.
Like a wash.
Everything else flabbed.
Looking like a lamb chop. Like, what is that?
Looking like a wasp. I just
don't want the queen bee.
Looking real sick. But now,
hey, but what y'all not about to do is just get on the females.
No, that's a lot of spray your edge up ass niggas out here, too.
Yeah. I was just about to say.
Hey, look, I'm thankful for my receiving hairline. Shoot.
But you know what? It's time for us to take care of ourselves. You know what I'm saying? It's time for us to fill in our beards.
If y'all can put weave in your head, nigga, we can damn sure find some dreads to put on real quick.
Oh, yeah, for sure. You know what I'm saying? Some Travis Scott's. Tory did it. Why we can't do it?
And he out of fucking line for that shit, too, because he looked weird as fuck.
Dude. Bro, you should see our reaction to that.
Man, I seen Jermaine Dupree, man. Do that mess.
Right here.
That nigga shit.
He said Tiger did it, so.
Yeah, Tiger did it.
Tory raised his eyebrows, nigga. Them hoes blend in his edge up around the hood.
It's tough, bro. Losing your hair as a man is a very, very tough. That's scary, bro. It's like a very, very.
Oh, I know.
Go ball, man. Rock it out.
It's just about our manhood. You know, it ain't got nothing else to do. It's just your manhood. You know, we come from the era of waves, do rags and shit growing up. So when you start losing your shit.
The problem is y'all brushed out hair too much and now your hair falling out.
Man,
I used to see boys like guys.
You know that school, always had their breasts on the string on the shoestring.
I'm like, bro, how many times you gonna brush your nephew's head? Like your waves gonna fall
no down. Waves.
Bro, no
they was trying to grow back
for 8 hours.
8 hours and no waves.
I ain't gonna lie.
You ain't even got a current in your head.
I was wavy. I ain't gonna lie. I was pretty wavy.
Yeah. Well, I know. Y'all. This might be my last time growing my hair. I embraced it. I'm just 30. It's coming off.
Is it going back?
No, it's going away.
that's what I meant, like going back, further back.
Yeah, my hair. I mean, I'm balding right here, and I'm receding. So 30 is.
Oh, you receding and balding.
Damn,
getting the train.
Got the Alex Caruso.
It's a train.
Your hair running the train.
Damn,
even got the Alex Caruso.
No,
he about to have that Calvin Murphy.
If it get worse before 30, then I'm cutting off because I'm not going to look like George.
If it get I'm worse before 30.
Look like Caruso. I'm not going to look like Stephen A. Smith.
I thought you was growing like it out.
None of them.
That boy got the cul-de-sac.
Wait, let's see, Devin. Devin, let me see.
No, bro.
She said the cul-de-sac. Malisha, I hate you, bro.
Bro, that picture, bro.
Are them regular tennis shoes with that suit?
them dress shoes, wow, bro. Don't do me.
Oh, them red bottoms. Go back to the picture. Let me see.
Boy, I can't afford no red bottoms.
That was a reflection of whatever he was standing on.
Them wood bottoms. That's what that is. Wood bottoms.
Wood bottoms, bro.
And I'm thankful. I work hard for them wood bottoms.
That's what I'm talking about, brother.
Hey,
you better style and profile.
I do too much walking. I ain't got time to buy J's and get rid of them in 8 months.
Got them 12 years of slaves on.
Message.
That's right.
Them how to get away with murders.
How to get away with murders.
Threes. But nah, just
looking like Sammy L from Django. Is that a nigga on that horse?
You know, it's probably the shoes he had on.
The Coon Sevens.
Oh, man.
Oh my God, y'all are funny, bro.
I love good jokes.
This is definitely a dope podcast, bro.
Facts, big facts.
More conversations to come, more serious
ones. Yes.
I don't know, has anything updated before we stop it?
Hold on.
I don't want to know.
Because I'm going to go ahead and post tomorrow, so that way we ain't too far off from the conversation. Mm-mm. I mean, y'all niggas 6 days late, man. It's just...
It's still 264.
Yeah, 264.
Let me see what Nevada's looking like.
Nevada. Do y'all know anybody?
They stopped. It's the same as it was a few hours ago. They actually stopped counting. They're not going to start back until tomorrow. But the other three can come in at any moment.
Because Georgia said they're not stopping until they're done.
If Biden fuck around, if Biden fuck around and get any of the three, it's over. It don't matter what anybody else does.
I don't know why they won't call it, but I know they won't call it because Trump is a sore loser. Duh. He's a sore loser, and he's already sued like 3 states.
He's suing already. Yes.
Biden already probably won any one of those 4, but they not gonna say nothing right now.
It's like they're walking on eggshells because honestly, Trump, whether he
never know what
believes it or not, or knows it or not, he has a lot of power, and they probably scared of what's gonna happen.
It says Pennsylvania has 800,000 uncounted votes right now.
Damn.
That's a lot of votes.
How many people did they hire? They only did 200,000 since this pie? Damn. Come on, Pennsylvania.
Man, like we said, man, shout out to the volunteers or workers that's counting these mail-in ballots, man.
Y'all are true MVPs, bro. Y'all are real heroes. But this is a dope podcast again for the last time. Episode 38 is in the books. Yep. I want to appreciate you guys for joining in again. Hope y'all have a tremendous and wonderful week. Keep
that's right.
First, keep loving. Everything good is going to come to you at its natural time. Y'all stay easy. You feel
all
me?
All right. Bishop Henry.